Christchurch, New Zealand's city of the plains. Here, when spring comes to Canterbury, daffodils bloom.
I think this is appalling. I'd be ashamed to bring anybody to have a look.
I don't know that we're not the garden city, but I think we're a different garden city to what we were.
Just after the National Exhibition in Hagley Park, Sir John Gorst, who was from the British government, came to Christchurch, and he was the first person to publicly say this was the garden city. And he likened it to some garden cities in England and suggested that Christchurch was the garden city that everybody wanted to aspire to.
There is always room for flowers and more flowers.
And as we moved through that 70s into the 80s and 90s, there was a movement to start developing a New Zealand garden identity as opposed to a transposed one from England.
This new competition came up, and I suggested to the city manager we should have a go at this. We covered all the criteria from heritage to landscape, community involvement, planning.
Did you expect to win?
Well, I was determined that I'd give it a fair shot.
The long history is, did a botany degree at Canterbury. I was a groundsman at Lancaster Park for many years. I've driven the odd roller. I fell asleep on a roller and crashed into the fence on the background. We're transitioning to, I would say, a much more naturalised space. A lot more focus on Indigenous planting. There is a resistance to change, you know, we still get faced from people that want to see the highly groomed lawn.
To me, they're not joyous. A garden should be something that you stop to look at, not walk past and just say, oh yes. My name is Elizabeth Peacock, and I am a past president of the Canterbury Horticultural Society. I think that over there is a disgrace, especially in front of the memorial wall. It's obviously lack of funding and lack of time and people for maintenance.
But I mean, they're not gardens.
They're dying.
That's a natural process. They'll recover. These plants will recover. They'll self-seed and they'll recover.
So no maintenance required?
Well, not no maintenance, but it's about making choices about where the maintenance is going to have the best effect with the funding and the resources we have available.
Why is that full of weeds?
I guess the guys are just a bit stretched, you know. It shouldn't be, there's no question.
This is more like it, a little bit of brightness and colour. Yes.
What
much
like?
Nicer.
Have a look at this. This is a problem that we're facing in public spaces. We need to understand that these plants don't live forever, and then we need to take it out and replant it again to bring it back to life. If I was bringing a visitor around here, I wouldn't bring them around here. It's just not nice.
People tell me there's not enough money to go around to employ more people. Other people say there's not the skills out there.
I think all of those things probably have some substance.
This is a southern rata tree, and it's dying here, and I wondered why. So it has had a look right down here at the base. Someone's used a weed eater here to clean the grass. Yeah, killing it off. I'm not sure about whether we need more people, but probably what we do need is some upskilling of existing people.
It is changing. There was a big shift to shifting everything out to contractors, but recently Council has taken on a lot more in-house work.
But there's no overall head honcho philosopher.
No, because I think what we need to recognise is that everyone has a voice.
He should have total control over the central area in terms of all the plantings, the landscaping, everything. I can't see how it can function otherwise. I really don't. It's just a nonsense to me.
Perhaps when the stadium is finished, there'll be a little bit more money in the coffers of the council.
We need to keep at it. We need to have this vision about what it is and what it can do for our society. I mean, we've got an election coming up, and that will be really interesting to see what the debate is. See, even if the name, the Garden City, is even used as part of that political debate. And if it's not, I think we'll be all disappointed.